Where do cookies come from? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. It may sound like a silly question, but it's actually truly legit when you think about the massive number of cookies you might find on your machine. Here's the question. I have cookies on my computer from websites that no one in my household said they had visited. Is this possible? Is there a way to tell if a cookie was an actual site visited or a third-party cookie? Well, to answer the second part first, no, not really, not easily for certain. There are many, many cookies on your machine. If you ever go into your browser settings and look at the list of cookies that have been deposited on your machine, you'll find that it's very, very long and is full of lots of sites that you never visited. That's normal. That's actually quite normal. Here's where they're coming from. One, of course, the sites you visit. That's the obvious one. If you go to askleo.com, there'll probably be a cookie for askleo.com. Those are the ones you expect. Resources from the sites that you visit. So if a site, a web page, includes an image, that image may come from another domain. For example, on some of my pages, I reference images from a completely different domain. So you'll be visiting a page on askleo.com, but a picture might come up that was actually stored on img.askleomedia.com. That's a completely different domain. It's a domain that I own. But the act of fetching that picture from that domain opens up the possibility for that domain to also leave a cookie on your machine. So you might find cookies from img.askleomedia.com on your machine, even though you never explicitly went there. It's because a web page that you visited needed something from over there. Now, in that same vein, advertising cookies are probably the biggest source of all these cookies that you don't recognize. And that's because advertising, if I take a look at the HTML behind ads that are on websites, good Lord, is it complicated. There's lots and lots and lots of different domains that are involved in putting those advertisements on your website. Bunch of different reasons, but they do come from a bunch of different places. The same thing applies. Every time you go out to fetch something from a website on the internet, that's an opportunity for that website to leave a cookie on your machine. And as we know, advertising systems definitely leave cookies. It's how they track you. It's how they provide you an ad for something that you are looking at over there once you're over here. So a lot of the cookies, I'll even venture to say most of the cookies that you might find on your system are due to advertisements. Now, pop-ups are an interesting one because pop-ups, whether they're ads or something else, they are often blocked, right? Even if you don't see the pop-up, your browser may be blocking them for you. There may be other things that are blocking them for you. So even though you don't see them though, there is a possibility that the whatever's being shown in that pop-up has been fetched from a web server. And that whole process was allowed to happen for enough time so that a cookie could have come from that website before the pop-up itself was actually blocked. So another possible source for things you never expect, things you never see, and certainly things you never visited are random pop-ups, whether you see them or not. And finally, what I call is cookies for sites you haven't been to yet. There's a feature in many browsers that basically when you're looking at a web page, it examines all of the links on that web page. And as it does so, it essentially prefetches those. In other words, it acts like it's fetching the web page from those different links just in case you click on them. Now, the fact that it's fetching those web pages means that, okay, there may be cookies involved. Cookies may get dropped because of this prefetch operation, even if you never go to that site. The whole point of the prefetch, of course, is that if you click on the link, all of that stuff is already there on your machine, and it comes up that much more quickly. But that's yet another source of cookies that can easily appear on your machine for sites and for things you've never gone to or that you've never even heard of. I hope that clarifies some of the confusion. For updates, for comments, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/4745. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.